The Senate will on Tuesday hold a special sitting to deliberate on contentious issues in the 2024-2025 finance bill after the National Assembly Committee on Finance concludes its public participation hearing on Monday.
Now, the sitting comes even as the bill continues to attract sharp criticism as calls to shoot it down when it comes to the floor of the House intensifies.
Anglican Church Archbishop Jackson Olesa Pitt has called on members of Parliament to completely do away with the bill in its entirety if it fails to accommodate the many suggestions made to the Finance Committee in the last 2 weeks. Kamau Mwangi reports.
It is race against time for the National Assembly Committee on Finance as it holds its final public participation exercise on the finance bill in a public forum at the KICC on Monday. And as revealed by Bomet Senator Hilary Sigei, Senate Majority Leader and Kericho Senator Aaron Cheruiyot has called for a special sitting Tuesday to discuss contentious issues in the bill.
Kamati ile ilikuwa inahusika, wamesunguka, wamepata maoni ya watu, ile vipengele karibu 60 na kitu. Zote siko sawa. Ile mbili tatu ine, watu wamesema wao tumevinyana hapa kidogo, tumevinyana hapa, hiyo wataiangalia kwa sababu tunahitaji pesa kama serikali ya Kenya kwanza ili CDF ikuje ijenge shule.
And even before the committee retreats to do a report on its two-week public participation, pressure continues to pile on members of parliament to shoot down the bill. The Anglican Church leading the charge with calls to MPs to completely do away with proposals that seek to further weigh on an already overburdened Kenyan populace.
The parliament needs to look at those taxation proposals and only bring to us taxes that are going to support the government effort to do mission in this country and develop, but those that are going to harm us and make the cost of living hard and also the cost of doing business hard should be done away with.
Sasa mwaka jana, hiyo bill ilikuwa kama ya Musa. Hii ya 2024 ndio mbaya zaidi, hii ndio ya Firauni yenyewe. Na ndio sababu we must all stand together in solidarity. Kupinga hii finance bill, sababu inapandisha kila kitu.
And where we are today, President Ruto, to your finance bill, we say no. We cannot see something coming to destroy us and we applaud it.
Awa na inchi ushuru inawamaliza. Ukiona avocado, ushuru. Ukiona kuku, ukiona mayai, ushuru. Ukiona gari, ushuru.
With the finance bill comes resources. Resources which the formula of sharing them in the country has become a hot potato topic, pitting friends and foes alike. DAP Kenya Party leader Eugene Wamalwa wants Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua's position on the sharing of revenue through the one man, one vote, one shilling formula respected, an opinion Senate Majority Leader Aaron Cheruiyot says can only be decided at the Senate.
This is a conversation whose time has come. Let us freely talk about it. Tusiwe tena na mambo ya vitisho, ama intimidation, ama isolation of any community or any individual, ama vilification of anybody. Anayekuwa na maoni tofauti na yako, na ama wewe na maoni tofauti na yake.
Kama Senate tutakaa na tutaangalia na tukubaliane ni njia vipi ambapo tukigawa mali ya Kenya, inafikia kona zote za Kenya na kila mwananchi anaridhika na tunakuwa na taifa bora. Kwa hivyo mambo ya kurushiana maneno kwa ma-TV na kusema mimi ni wa hii, mimi ni wa ile, hiyo ni mambo hewa mnaongea.
With Treasury Cabinet Secretary Professor Njuguna Ndungu expected to table budget estimates for the 2024-2025 financial year on Thursday, a meeting that had been called by President William Ruto to whip members of his ruling Kenya Kwanza administration into passing the finance bill has been postponed to next week. It remains to be seen how members of parliament move around incorporating views collected and pass a bill favorable to Mwananchi. Kamau Mwangi, Citizen TV.